So this last tank is just about empty. Once it's empty, we're gonna start the blowout. And that is, with the mallet, I'll hit the tank, get all the product off the side of the walls around the tank, and then I'll reopen the valve until it's completely empty. Product valve and aerator valve. It'll take all about a minute. Then I will close the aerator valve and the product valve, and I'll do the same on down the line. Open the product valve, aerator valve, and let whatever's at the bottom of the tank spew out into the silo about a minute or less. Close that and repeat. Open the product valve and the aerator valve, and let the product flow. Then once all those are closed, we'll move on to how to release pressure. So the hose has stopped moving. That means my tank is empty. I've already hit the tank. Blowout is already done. We'll close this. Close this. Open the second. Let that run for about a few seconds. Close it, close it, go back to the first tank, open, open. Open that up. Release all the pressure. Go back over here. That change will be zero. Then you go from here into the truck. Flip down your PTO switch.
There you have it. Now what we're about to do is break it down, because we're done. So first thing first, you want to make sure that all the air pressure is released, which we did with the blowdown valve right there, right here. And then we turned off the PTO switch. That means there's no more air flowing through the tank. So now what we're about to do is unlatch the hose that feeds the air through the tank. Put the cap back on. Take the hose, put it in this little thingy, right, this holder right beyond the hose itself. I'll show you in a minute. Now I'll take the hose and put it here. Now that I lock the hose in this holder, I'll now start to detach the hose from the truck. And as you can see, there's no pressure, no air. You definitely don't want back air flowing through, or product flowing through if there's any left. You don't want to breathe the stuff in. So you can see there's no air here. Once I detach the hose from the truck, I'll come over and then detach the holes from the silo. That's it. That's all you need to know. So to reiterate how you unload a bulk trailer, first thing you do is to take your hose and place it here. Then you walk back, open up your aerator valves only. Then you go to the back and you hook your hose, which is of course, found here, to the back of the truck, and then to the silent. Then you go into your truck. Take your clutch and your gear, put it into first, second gear, whatever, and get the pressure going. It'll go up to 6,000, but you want to press down on the accelerator, get it up to 11,000 or whatever is required at the time. Come out. Once your pressure reaches 11,000, you in your truck, then you want to watch your gauges. Make sure they go up to 11,000. Once those gauges reaches the point of 11,000 or a little higher, then you come out here, open up your product valve, and open up your aerator valve or your pressure control valve. And then you repeat all the way down the line. Once the tank is empty, go to tank 2. And once that's empty, go to tank 3. Repeat. That's it.